My name is Amir, and my topic today is about NoSQL web application vulnerabilities and mitigations. First, a few seconds about me. I'm an experienced technical manager. I've worked in high-tech companies for around 20 years. I've done roles of development, team leading, group management, project management, system engineering, and research. And the last 9 years, I've been working in three leading security vendors, Checkpoint, Radware, and recently CyberArk. Okay, let's go over the table of content, what we're going to discuss, some abstract and introduction, what are web application vulnerabilities, NoSQL, difference between SQL, denial of service, SQL injection, Ajax, same origin policy, CSRF, JSON queries, and then examples of injections to NoSQL. Phishing, REST API, and mitigations. And there is also a new type of mitigation I will display later on. Okay, so what is NoSQL? In the last year, we see that NoSQL databases are getting very popular. Because they're of their scalability and they're very easy to use. In this lecture, I will show you that there is very similar injection method to what we used to know in SQL injection that will also work in NoSQL. And we'll also review mitigation solutions. A reminder about NoSQL that it does not use authentication, encryption, and role management is usually optional. So as a result, it is vulnerable also to denial of service, distributed denial of service, and the injection impact is much more effective. Okay, some introduction on this lecture. Database security, very important aspect in every web application development. Accessing the database can grant you control over all the critical data. SQL injection attacks allows us to update, create, and delete this data, have declined throughout the years, and are not relevant to NoSQL. However, the new access method that NoSQL provides are still vulnerable to injection attacks, and I will demonstrate a few of these methods. Okay, let's give an example. What are web application vulnerabilities? We're discussing a weakness in a web application that can be exploited to perform unauthorized actions. Many web applications can be used, even, for example, by a simple web browser. For example, SQL injection, just adding a parameter to the URL is enough to run a successful attack. Okay, a few lines about what is NoSQL. NoSQL stands for non-relational SQL, a recent, relatively new type of database, which saves data in non-relational structure. It has four categories. Basic one is the key value, for example, Redis, which is a sort of hash table. Another one is the white column. Other one is the document. If you use the MongoDB, it means that the value itself has a more complex data structure. And the final type is the graph, which is used to store information about a network or social connections. So here's an example of SQL versus NoSQL. If you can see, in the table, so NoSQL has no integrity constraint. You just have a key, and all the relevant data is saved in a single value. While the while standard SQL has integrity constraint of primary keys and foreign keys, which are primary key, which refers a foreign key, a key which refers to a primary key of another table. Okay, let's discuss about denial of service. It's an attack which sends traffic to cause a network resource to become unavailable. If we have a distributed denial of service, it's the same as DOS, but it uses multiple sources for traffic. Today we have solution for this, for example, using black whitelist and recently behavioral analysis of the network. Here's an example of illustration of denial of service, where multiple endpoints are used to form an attack. Okay, let's go over SQL injection before we see how can we have no SQL injection. SQL injection, basically a code injection for attacking web application, which read input. The idea is that the attacker will insert SQL into the entry fields, so they will be executed by the web application. For example, the classic example is to add one equals one, which still works in many websites, which results into a query where you are selecting all the users and one equals one, which means you are selecting all the users and adding a comment to the part of the password. We're also going to discuss the AJAX, so just reviewing what it means. Asynchronous JavaScript and XML, this is a method for creating interactive web applications. It's based on a code which runs in a single HTML, usually implemented in JavaScript. It just sends a HTTP XML request using POST or GET to update part of the page dynamically. Same origin policy will also be used in this presentation. It is important concept in web application security. It means that the web browser, which runs a script, is only allowed to access another page if they have the same origin. Origin means a combination of URI, hostname, and port number. CSRF, an attack in an end user which perform action on his behalf. This can be done by preparing a web page which submits an HTTP request when it is loaded and sending a phishing email to an authorized user to trick him into opening this page. Let's see a CSRF example. Here's a GET scenario. Application was designed to use the GET request to transfer money. So transfer operation can contain transfer.do and amount and action, and amount and account. So an exploit can run transferring money to his account while the user is not aware that this operation is happening. Discuss JSON. JSON is a lightweight data interchange format. This is used by MongoDB, and we'll see it in the example later on in this presentation. It's much more defined than SQL, but still can be exploited. Let's see an example. For example, in MongoDB, if I want to query for a user, then I will ask for db.tablename.find, and here I'll put key and value, and similar way to insert to a table. We'll see soon how to use JSON and PHP array injection to perform NoSQL injection. So let's see what PHP array injection means. And basically, it means that instead of passing values to PHP, we are passing an array. So if I pass an array instead of the values, so it will be translated into an array in the query, and we will see it, how can this be used to perform an injection. Okay, let's go to an example which will show us how to use PHP array injection to create NoSQL injection. So what I do is, instead of writing username equals my user and password equal my password, I'm writing username brackets, $NE, brackets equals one, and password brackets, $NE, brackets equals one. And this actually results into an array. So it will result in the following code, that db, for example, logins.find, and it will look for a username dot $NE one and password $NE one. This means $NE in MongoDB means not equal. So it means it will give us all the user and passwords which are different than one. So what actually is a very simple way, where just because we're transferring instead of get as a response all the users, which password and the username are not equal to one, probably result in getting all the users. Okay, so can be done also in another way. For example, if I'm using a very naive way to run a NoSQL query, then I'm saying, okay, dollar query equals username dot, this is a PHP example, dot dollar get username, password dollar get password, and I'm querying I'm using this query to find the user. Then if I use an example of an input I can use, that similar to what we use in SQL injection, but here's a different syntax. There are several methods I can do this. I chose the $in, which is allows us to check if the username is matches some regular expression, which matches everything. It can also be done with the $or. It's also be done in $gt, which means greater than, and perform a query which will give us all the username and password which match any regular expression, which means all the users. Instead of $in, again, I could use other expression also. There's several types. I gave this example because I actually tried it. I didn't want to give anything I didn't try myself. This is a working example of NoSQL injection. Okay, so let's discuss a bit about phishing. It's about a fraud attempt to get secure information using electronic communication. For example, I will create a site similar to Yahoo, and then I will send a link to a user, and I will tell him that his account was breached, and will ask him to re-enter his credentials. Use an example of phishing email. Alerting a user that his account was breached. Also mentions URL of Microsoft. The only catch here is that if user will actually press the link, it will lead to a similar site, but not obviously not the Microsoft site. Usually it's very easy to detect phishing emails since the origin of the email is not from the vendor it claims to be. Another thing we will display later is the REST. REST is about an architecture for creating web services, which allows simple stateless HTTP access. but also exposes the users to CSRF. So let's see an example of how REST can be used for CSRF. I have a form which action is changing the price, and when the form is uploaded, I'm submitting it without user consent. Okay, so just when the, if you can see when. The user is selling to zero. We discussed role-based access that is not used by it's not used by NoSQL by default. Basically, it's a good practice that every user will have a different role and will have permissions limited by his actual needs. It also minimizes possible damage in case of a breach. Okay, let's. The next stage is to discuss. This is a sort of innovative solution for NoSQL. It's the more interesting part of this lecture. What I will discuss is it's called DND. It's not my work. It's based on an article. It's called. It's a dynamic NoSQL detection. It's a solution which acts as a proxy between the web server, the web browser, and the web server for detecting and dropping injection attempts. Many times we cannot modify all the application code to block any injection attempts, or maybe we thought we changed all the code, but still we missed out on something. So in such cases, it's very good that we'll have a proxy that will allow us to block such attempts. It has several parts. I will review them in the next slide. A server, online judge, parameter separator, modeler, comparator, login repository for monitoring, and MongoDB, which is the database which is protected. Okay, so let's discuss the parts we saw earlier. The server is parsing the. We're discussing a protection about HTTP injection attempts to NoSQL. So the server is parsing the HTTP request and splicing the query into parameter we call Q1. Let's give an example. For example, I'm calling login PHP and I'm giving it a username and a password, and at the end I'm also trying to inject. So this will be what this will be the first parameter, the Q1, which will be sent to the online judge. We have a parameter separator, which will receive. A template of how the HTTP request should look like. And for here, example of how it will look like. For example, it will be like login.php, username equals brackets, and password equals brackets. And next, we have the modeler, which will create trees from this request. We will see in the next slide how it is done. We have a comparator, which will compare this. And if they don't have the same structure, it will drop the request and log. If it is the same structure, it will pass it to MongoDB. And the repository to save illegal requests. So if I go back to the slides, so we have a server which sends the request, online judge which creates the parameter, system. Okay. Okay, what is the basic algorithm here? The idea is that each MongoDB shell statement can be parsed into a tree. And when we try to perform an injection, the structure of the tree will be different. So the algorithm is indifferent to which type of injection you want trying to do. It will eventually result in a different type of tree. The algorithm used for building the parse tree is called the extract structure algorithm. We will demonstrate in the next slide how it is done. For example, first we need to classify characters into operators. For example, equal semicolon will be an operator, and the keywords, here we use JavaScript, so var, etc. And then we will divide the string into operators and keywords to create the parse tree. For example, if the query is in the code is $q equals var id dot $get id, so we first divide it by equal operator and then by var, and the input will be placed on the right side. Let's see an example. So here the base is the root, equal splits the tree into var and the value, which is 12, and the next node will be the ID. Another example will be if $q equals var ID $get ID, and we have if this dot ID equals ID, then let's see how it will be split into. This is an example of a code which contains an injection by using this dot ID equals equals ID. So as you can see, it is creating a totally different tree, because the injection uses operators, and so it is split into additional subtrees. The injection here is split into another tree, into another subtree, so it's not even similar to the model of the original request, and it doesn't. The algorithm is indifferent of how and which syntax we will try to use to create the injection. In any case, it will not result in the same tree. So this will save us problems that, for example, a web application firewall have of detecting injection, which can be in various forms. So let's see how the deployment will look like. We have a web browser tries to send a valid input or NoSQL injection to the DND framework. In case it's a legal query, we pass it to the web server and return the data. If not, we can decide if we want to display a warning or just drop the request. This is a security decision. And anyone has any questions about the framework?
Can you talk anything about the performance
and impact of the system? It's based on an article, so I can refer you to see that there has been a test on performance, and but what I'm lacking in details are the exact comparison of the trees. I didn't find the details on that, which is interesting in this aspect. But there is an article on this which also shows the performance and the false positive. There were none in this test, but it doesn't mean there will be none. So let's discuss a bit about the conclusion of this presentation. So NoSQL, we have a new query and access method which are much more structured than SQL. However, every new method and access is still vulnerable to injection. Historically, SQL injection anti-exploitation techniques will also work here. For example, restricting input, escaping it input, parameterized queries, least privilege roles. And again, what I've displayed, if changing the web server code or is not possible or not possible to change all the code, there's another solution displayed, which is the DND mechanism. I think that's about it. If anyone has any questions, feel free to ask. Yes? Access file using NOSQL injection?
Yeah, for instance.
There are different things you can do using NOSQL injection. I didn't display it here because the example is a little complicated to show. But NOSQL injection also supports JavaScript. So anything you can do with the JavaScript, you can do that. So there's example. NoSQL using MapReduce. So MapReduce uses JavaScript. So in this case, you could also do like anything you want using a JavaScript. And the NoSQL injection engine will run it. I didn't check all the possible modifications, but I think it's quite it's quite huge. The options that are possible using JavaScript run by the server.
But I would assume that these are usually stripped down engines. So there's a limitation to what can you send requests or
I don't think I didn't find the specific restriction. So I can assume some of them at least will be pretty reckless. Okay. Thank you.